If you would like to know more about Lord Shri Krishna, please subscribe to our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon.
Now when you eat food, now I'm not talking about the, I told you, if you associate, through a science has also agreed to this. I read this article of biochemist from United States only, because there's a lot of research they do. We stated that what you eat has got an effect on your body and mind. But they do not know what food has got effect on your mind. What mind? What food has got what effect? English saying, what you eat, you are. Jaisa ann vaisa man, jaisa pani vaisi vani, jaisa ahar vaisa vyavhar. Very famous saying. And that's what Krishna says. In the Bhagavad Gita also he says. But now, let us talk foods in the mode of passion and ignorance are useless. Are? Because they'll confuse you. Or they'll make you think right to be wrong and wrong to be right. Now, what are the foods in ignorance passion? Meat, fish, eggs, onion, garlic, and in pulses, lentils, masoor dal. These are foods, and food cooked 3 hours before eating is all in mode of passion and ignorance. That's what everything is going on in America, is it not so? There was a big fight. Once there was a South Indian family in Bombay. The mother-in-law would not allow the daughter-in-law to bring in a fridge. And there was a big fight. And then she called the son separately to her room. You know this, your wife will basically make things and keep it for, you're going to eat it for five days. That's why I don't want the fridge in. So then he said, they had an agreement that she'll only keep milk. She'll only keep milk, nothing else. But today mothers are not mothers. They give them noodles. What? 2 minute noodles. Maggi noodles. Very famous here also. Nana Prabhu, is it right or not? They do not know what's the importance of food. That's why Krishna says that if you, now food in the mode of goodness is other things, leaving aside meat, fish and eggs, onion, garlic, and now see, sometimes people say, that's why I told you, no vegetarian, non-vegetarian in our shastras. We are more technical. What effect is it is going to have on your mind? Because 90% of your diseases which are there today, American Medical Journal accepts it that 90% of them are due to psychosomatic. And that starts from food. Because without food, you cannot live. And that also, people will ask you, but plants, grains, when you eat them, they also have life? Absolutely right. If you eat those also, you are doing two activities. Paap and pun both. Paap and pun both. Because you have to eat. That's what Vedas say. Jivas jivo jivanam. One life is food for the other life. It states. But it is human form of life you can decide. If a tiger wants to become vegetarian, can it become vegetarian? No. And a goat wants to become non-vegetarian? No. It's gone. But we can, because we can decide our future. We have been given the free will. We can decide. So not also goodness will not help us. So how do you change? So in the third chapter of the 13th shloka, Krishna is saying very clearly, yagya shishta sino santo muchante sarva kil vishai, that my devotees are free from all type of sin because they first offer food to me. That is called bhog. Bhog means to enjoy. So who is the owner of everything? Lord Shri Krishna says, I am the owner. Aham sarvasya prabhavo. I am the master and owner of everything. So everything should be first offered to him. So when you offer that food to him, it is known as bhog. Bhog is a Sanskrit word which means enjoyer. That's why when you offer to the Lord, it is known as bhog. And when you offer it to him and you pray to him that please accept it. So people say, he does not eat it, it's lying there only. That is called purna. We are a purna. This glass of water, I drink, it becomes half. Because I am a poon. Anything I touch becomes a poon. But when the Lord drinks the whole glass of water, it stays the same way. That is called poon. Samadhi, you understood now the meaning of poon. That is what actually poon means. He eats the whole food and still it remains there. So what does he eat? What does he take away? He takes away the sins. He says, Yagya, my devotees are freed from all type of sins because they eat only food which is offered to me as bhog and then take it as prasad. And the word prasad means mercy.